Hello guys, how are you? I'm here again trying to continue with the new stream. Let's see if everything works the way it should. And we're going to work again on the scene that we were doing these days. I'm going to try to model. I fixed the mouth of the bear. As you can see over here, I already have a new face. I could have done a better job here and over there, but I don't really care. It's going to be seen from this side. So right now it doesn't look like a hound anymore. I make the snout smaller and the mesh looks better right now. It is not quite like the reference. As you see, we have some little details, minor details. Maybe I could change a little bit here and take this guy over here and a little bit the mesh over here. Remember that we're going to put fur on this big guy, so I need to make the selection wider because I have a lot of information there that I want to keep. And I don't want to mess with information over there. So I have my base mesh almost like the mesh that I have here. So let's see if I can start making the model. The model that we have over here is the mesh on the forest. So we're going to start working on the forest right now. Let's see if we can work a little bit the mesh and everything as we should. If I take as a reference the grid that I have over here, I can see that. Let's bring a new box, make it wider, a little bigger, and let's put the box on top of my mesh. So I will try to align my mesh and the box, something like that. Let me see if I have a rotate in which angle do I need. I need a rotation on X angle. So the rotation on X, it's -6. I have a -5, almost the same rotation. Okay. So I have the rotation the way I should have the rotation. And let's try to see if everything looks correctly. If I take the grid that I have here into account, the mesh should be something over there. So let's select this face, move my face, maybe a little bit over here and something like that. Okay, that should be the basic mesh over here, and I'm just trying to block everything out. So let's try to see, this one should be the mesh that is behind. So I'm going to select this face. I'm going to make an extrude again with object, so it should follow the guide. And no, it is not over there. This one should be a little bit more over here, maybe. Let's see. Yeah, it should be over here. As you saw, I was making it with a perspective here, but it should be there as you saw here in the artwork. So that should be the second, and I can see something over here. Let me open the file, the one that has the final artwork, to see. Over here I can see a little shape. I'm trying to make this shape. This artwork is from If Skylar from Neon 4. So I'm trying to make this shape. The shape that I was struggling right now was this one that is behind. And I can see that I have like a lake over here, and I'm trying to make this shape. So let's work over here. Maybe if the reference was correct, I was correct actually when I was doing the first change. So it's a little bit over here. And this part, I will try to make another cut, maybe over here. Yep, I like that cut. If you guys have something to ask me, it will be great. I'm over here, okay. So I'm going to extrude everything out of camera. I don't care, because I need this guy to be out of camera. So that should be the block. And now I need to make the block from the other side. For this one, I'm going to extrude everything, like really everything. And I can see that the perspective is not quite right here. So I'm going to make everything up. That should be it. So right now I have a better perspective, and let me see if the toes, no, he's not touching. So that's right there. And I have to make a cut again over here to make the extrude. Maybe the cut should be this one. Okay, let's see if I take this guy and I make this guy come over here. This one should be the base. So with this basic shape, I have the base for my mesh. I'm going to hide the burr and maybe this one should be a little bit over here. Okay, that's it. So next I'm going to refine the base mesh. And this one should be like this. I'm going to put fur and other things on top of the mesh. So that should be done with quite easy steps. Something like this. And I need a bigger resolution. I'm going to add some mesh, some subdivisions. In a moment. I need first try to get the basic shape with the least polygons that I can. If I add more polygons before the basic shape, I'm going to struggle trying to get the right blocking out of this guy. So I have something like that over here. And I think that over here. So I'm making the basic shapes out of the model. And I have everything here and here. I need to add some shapes. This part is thinner. Maybe something like that. Remember that I'm trying to get the same perspective, so it's not that easy. And I need to make it carefully so it looks at least on the same perspective. Oh, will have to add more loops over here to get the basic shape of the shore. Let me see, it's something like that. And on this one, it's smaller. I don't have a hill here. We have a hill, it goes down. So I have a hill over here. It goes down and a hill again, and it goes down. And over here, I have this mesh, and I think they have a corner over here and something like that over here. And so I have to make everything. I have to make the boxes, the rocks, and the shrubs that I have there, and the basic shape over here. So let's try to get this mesh. Right now I have the blocks, and this block should be right. Let's try to get this one over here. Over the shore. I'm trying to get that vertex on the shore. This vertex, which vertex is this one? I don't need this vertex. No, I don't need this one. I should remove everything that is on this side. Let's remove these guys. Let's remove these guys. Because they are getting, making noise and the information that I got here. So maybe I prefer to have them. You see, these two guys should be way back. And this guy, for the perspective, should be over here. And this guy should be over here. So right now I have the final perspective for the shore. You see, they were doing some noise on the information that I was receiving from the end. So right now I do have the shirt the way I should. So they are thinner there. And this side and this side should go over here. So I have to fix both of these guys and this guy. That's why I need to make everything with the least quantity of information, or with the least kind of geometry and number of polygons, because it's going to be quite hard to make this kind of changes with too much information. I have to make this sandy thing, bitch, something here, bitch. Sorry. I will try to make everything the way they should. This guy should be over here, and this one should be over here. So it's not that easy to get this shape. Okay. This is old school box modeling. As you can see, I really like to do these things with box modeling. I know I can do everything on ZBrush and everything, but I really like the control that I have when I'm working with box modeling. It's great to know that I can change everything, and it's going to behave the way I like, and I can have the geometry behave as I like, and to add just a loop where I want to add a loop and where I need to add a loop. I just like to work with old school box modeling for this kind of thing. I did model the bear with box modeling, but also I changed it with ZBrush and the basic shapes. You can see the last stream was about the modeling and the box modeling of this guy. That was the first stream. The second stream was ZBrushing this big boy. And this stream, it's going to be about the environment. I'm going to try to block everything out. Let's see. Here, on this part, we have weird shapes. So maybe I will need to put this thing here and here. This shape is not normal. So if I move everything here, I will need to add that shape. Let's see if I can add the shape on the perspective, directly on the perspective. And should it make us extrude from here? Let's try. I don't know if it's going to work. I'm going to try to make this extrude from the beginning and to make it, I think it's too much. Yeah, it's not going to work this way. I should just add a new loop for everybody and make the extrude from this new loop. Yeah, it's better. So this guy, it's going to be thin over here. And let's see, it's wavy. So this guy, it's wavy. And we should add some loops to make it wavy. I'm going to add just 3 loops. I'm not going to make too much at the beginning. This one should be over here. This one should be over here. He can be over here. Okay. So we have the loops. I'm going to make this thing wider because it should be wider. The base, it's the only thing that we see, but under the river, under the water, we should have a main shape, and that main shape, it's going to be the one that behaves correctly and give us all the information from the refraction and the rock bed of the river and everything. So let's try to make it wider. And maybe a little bit over here. So with this, we should have the main shape of that river for that scene. And I don't really want to add anything else. Just make this guy smaller over here, thinner over here. And that should be it. Maybe a little bit off. Information. As you see, I thought that this one was close, but it's really a long way from the other part. So this should be the blocking. I have to make a basic shapes and some interesting shapes here on the beach. So something like that, like here and here. I think it's closer over here. Yeah. Okay. With that, I have the basic plane for the shore, just the shore. Now I need to add some information to get everything the way it should. On the back part, I see some bulges and some parts of the mesh that should be and should have more information. So I'm going to make the grid And I'm going to sculpting Maya. I'm crazy, right? So let's duplicate this plane. I'm going to hide the plane that I duplicate, and I'm going to move to sculpting. And I'm going to get my old welcome, my friendly pet. And it's working. I hate welcoming Maya in servers, in Windows. It's always too risky to use because we never know if it is working or it is not working. Okay. It is not. Let me see. Yep, it's working. So let's try to make the strength to 200 to see if now. Okay. So this part over here, strength to 1000. Yep, too much. 500. This part over here should be the rocks. So I'm going to block out the rocks. I need to move my plane to the back. And dip. Too much. Okay. So I have everything here. It works similar to Sivers, but I can have more control over here. So that's why I work with this tool. I know everybody hates sculpting in other programs, but I don't really care. I just want to block everything out. And let's move over here and make the brush bigger. And that should be the base of that tree. As you can see, with control, it works the same as ZBrush. And also I have a configuration for my Wacom tablet to work with Maya. I don't know if people can work with other softwares, and it's not that bad, actually. The sculpting tools in Maya got better on the latest release. So why not? Let's try them out. And actually I like them. So for this part over here, I should use something like this. It's too much. Okay, let's try to get it from this side. So over here, I need a little bit more, not that much. And the perspective seems to be working, right? So I right now have the blocks for my geometry. I don't know, this one should be the one, this one should be the one. So I have the block for the geometry. Now I'm going to block out the trees. We have a lot of trees here. I can see, let me see, well, let's see. Let's move to here. Here I can see a lot of guys. The first one is this guy over here. So we have one tree. We have a second tree. Let me change the colors to block all the trees out. So we have a second tree here. We have a third over here. And if I use all my imagination, I can see a little bit more. Let's see. I can see this one over here. Why? Because if I go with a black and white, I can see how the light passed through everything. So it should be easier that way. I can see this one also. So we had 5, 6, 6 maybe, 6 and 7, 7. I could say 7. I don't know. I think we have 2 more trees here, 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 and here. So we have 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 trees. I think 10 trees. This one should be a tree on the back part. So we have 10 trees. We have to make everything. So let's try to get the 10 trees out. First, let's go to the big ones. The big ones are the easiest. I always like to work with cubes. I like the cubes. So this one should be behind this part, so it's a big tree. It's really big. And should be something like that over here, and maybe like this. And it's wider. And I get the idea that it's not only wider, it's quite a big tree. So, okay, that should be the base. And let's move again with extrudes. So I'm using the 2 windows. This window is to move and to see the result. And this one is just to block everything out. I press G to repeat. And I'm going to keep going up to get the idea where this tree is going. And just to block the shapes out. Now I'm going to take everything with a soft selection, and I'm going to make the tree a little bigger, this is not work. Okay, that's it. Thinner on the top. I need the tree to be thinner on the top because it's too really big on the sides. And after that, let's block out the other trees. I have the base shape, so I shouldn't care. This one it's behind, but I think it's not that big. It's smaller. Let's see how we paint it. Yeah, it's smaller. And the shape is different also. I think that the base of this tree is wider. And it's more over here. And something like this. And not too much over here. Okay. So that should be the second tree. I know this part is not that funny to see. I'm just blocking out trees. I promise that everything should be better soon. Okay, that's the second one. And it shouldn't be like that. This one, I think it's getting closer to the camera. I can see that this guy, it's coming here and it's getting wider. So maybe it's like that. Let's see, it's coming close. So it should be something like that. Yep. So I have 2 trees. I need a 3rd. Let's take another one. And with this one, I'm going to start again. I don't want to have the same shapes on every single tree that I make. This one again then appears to be behind this guy. And this is a main tree also. So it's over here. And let's try a different way to make the tree. So I'm going to make the box. I'm going to go up and to try to get the shape. senior on the top. I'm going to go up. I'm going to create a loop. And again. And repeat and repeat and repeat. So, it's not that hard to make the trees. The hard part is I'm going to make some angles. They're the happy trees from Bob Ross, guys. And it's not that hard to make the trees and to make it fit your perspective once you have your perspective. The hard part here is to get the actual perspective to work. This one was an easy perspective. I just have one, two angles of view. So the perspective is easy to get. If you have like three angles, it's a hell. And if you have almost no references for the way that the horizon is working and that kind of stuff, it's hard to get your perspective to work. Let's see. So I have two thinner trees over here. And let's try the big one on the side. So I have this one here. And let's make a big one. Let's save. I want to save the scene. I should save always. We always should save. Maya, it's a pain in the sometimes. So it's better if we save a lot. This one, it's really big. This is the bigger tree that we're going to have here. This one appears to be like two rocks with everything, with all kind of stuff over there. And yeah, so let's try to block the scene again. And this is a really big tree. This part should be over here, and you can see that the base is not enough. Let's block this guy out. Something like this. And I think that the base should be over there. It's quite big. Maybe it's bigger than this, because I think that in the artwork I can see this shape going over the other shapes. So something like that, maybe. And this part is something like this here. Yeah. So like that. And behind. Okay. I think like that should work. And let's go up. We're trying to climb that big weird tree. It's not going to be easy. I'm going to put some loops on this one. This one is, it's one of the principal trees we're going to have here, so I really want to put loops before time. I will try to sculpt the trees on ZBrush, but for the shapes I try to get everything as close as possible to respect the shape on ZBrush and not lose everything out. So let's see if I can get the scene work. This tree is not an easy one to make. I think that I have the basic shape there. No, I don't. So you see here, I'm losing some, so it should be wider, even wider than that. Or maybe this part is the one that I'm not having right. And again and again and again. So let's extrude. As you saw, this is a really big scene. I'm working with real scale scenes, So I should here far clip plane, and I go over so I can now see everything out. Let's see. And okay, I think that I should make this guy bigger, just a tiny bit. It's a really big tree, so you see this is a big, really big jungle. And let's see, we have some other trees, 1, 2, 3, 4. For this one, it's a bigger tree like this. I'm not going to make everything out again. I'm just going to change the shapes to go with the real shape. This one is behind, and appears to be something like this. And I'm going to move this guy over here. Okay, this is the second one. So I have almost all the trees, the main trees. I have to add more information behind everything, but this one should be enough. And let's see. There are a lot of trees, actually, and really, really big trees. So I should take, yeah, I like this one. So the other trees are thinner and are on the back. So they are on the back, are thinner. Maybe I should make the thinner trees from top to bottom. And let's see if I can see them. Someone was over here, and the movement, it's here. I see them now. Okay, I can see him. He's here and he's like over there. And the second one, I can see a little bit part of him. He should be something over here. And let's change the size. No, just not to look like the other one. And which one is on the back, which one is on the front? I think this one, it's thicker. It's a little bit thicker, not that much. And this one should be in the front. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I had a lot more than that. And the next one should be this one here. Yeah. And that one should be behind on top of this tree. So in between this one and this one should be a tree. So let's make this one bigger and thinner, and this one a little bit over here. And I want to move this big guy and to rotate him over here. And on the artwork, I can see that it's going over the side, but it's falling always like a little bit straight and from the base. So it's falling over the side, but on the base he's a little bit straight. So this should be all the trees. So we have the basic shape blocked out from everything. We have the dunes over here. We have everything. I need to start making the grasses, and I need to start making the shapes here. And I need to do the back of the tree, the lock, and this part here. That part I can just cut. Let's see, duplicate this guy. I'm going to use a lot of things to fill the tree with leaves and some fungus and things growing on the tree. So maybe if I take this guy over here and move him, make him thinner, and let's see. See the artwork, it's falling behind the leg, and I think this part should be higher. So let's see. This is the tree. Oh, I kill my tree. This is not the tree. I hate when that happened. I don't know when did that. I know when did that happen. Okay, so this should be the tree. Let's see how it looks. Maybe I should go for our models. I think it's not going to work. Ah, it's working. It's working. It's working. Yeah, it's working. I'm going to leave this tree or with this shape. And let's bring our bear. So right now I have my bear. Let's make a quick render just to see how it's behaving with lights. I'm going to remove this part here. Lights seem to be coming from behind the trees, from everything behind. I have like some shapes over here. I need to make the water and everything, but let's try to have a basic render. So I'm going to save, I'm going to redshift on light and redshift physical sky. Maybe not. I'm going to create the physical sky from over here. Create. So I have everything on everywhere. So this one should be from the perspective, and this is from the camera. And let's see if I have a physical sky. Right, one physical sky, like two. I'm going to move to viewport one. Let's look for my physical sky. This is a physical light. I don't want my physical light. I want my sun direction. And the sun direction should come over here. Something like that, and let's see how does this thing renders. And I was working with Redshift. That's weird. Okay, I lost the materials. So let's put some basic materials to everyone. So select all, and let's apply this material to everyone, and let's see the render results. And we're having a great look on the things. The shapes are not that right, but it's looking not that bad, actually. I'm missing some trees. Let's see. So this tree should be over here. Maybe a little bit over here. And this tree should leave a little gap over there. And this one should be closing this little gap over here. Okay. So, it doesn't look bad. Do we have the eye? No, I don't have the eye. So, brute force and brute force. So, I'm getting close. Maybe configuration should be a little bit different, but I don't care. This tree should be wider. See, this tree should block the light coming from here, and it should be wider also on the base, because this guy is also blocking the light coming from the other angles. So, like that. This tree is okay. Here I have a space on top of the head of the guy. Maybe I should move him in between the head. I have a space here. Yeah, I have that right. And this part, that's not a side. This shouldn't be here. Maybe I'm missing some. I think that the thing that I should do is to duplicate this guy, to rotate him on the back, make him bigger, and put him over here. So I have a better looking guy over there. And I should fake these guys also and make a group, put them, all of them, over here, and like this, because I think that we should have a lot of information on this tree, and we should have a close environment for this guy to be here, like, so happy. He shouldn't be there with a lot of weird guys looking at him. He should be sleeping so peacefully on a great environment. So he shouldn't be worrying about someone trying to steal his food or to wake him up. The light, maybe. I have the light here on this part. Maybe something like this. Because I have the shape and the shadow of the guy here. And I can see the trees very small on the back part, so I should change the back part of the tree is way bigger here, so let's see if I can change that. Here the tree should be bigger, like way bigger, getting here. So this part here, it's the tree actually. I was getting that part wrong. I should stop the render. Redshift is quite fast for this kind of stuff, so it renders amazingly fast. I will try to change that part. I have everything is stuck at this moment. Redshift decide that Maya should stop working. So I try to change something that is taking a lot of RAM right now. Well, not a lot, it's with 2 gigabytes of RAM working. So that's okay, it's not that bad. Okay, it's not working and I have not saved for a big while. So let's kill this thing and try to wait. This should work. Okay, we are here again. So let's try to kill this renderer. Okay, we're back. So let's save, right? Save. And let's try again. I'm going to change this guy over here. I should scale him completely. I should scale this guy. I don't know. I should take this guy to ZBrush and scale him there. I know the shape, I know everything. Okay, I'm going to go to ZBrush. Let's try to scale him here. So, something like this. I don't care about the back part. I'm not going to render this part. I should make it. I should take into account the perspective and the volume. It's going to help have the volume right. I shouldn't touch the part of the back part. It should be, I think, in between its butts, in between its buttocks. I don't know, but almost here. Okay, let's see. It's bigger here. And I will take a damn standard to make it look right. The same thing is going to happen. I'm going to put some shrubs and some fungus and some and everything on top of him. So I don't really care the way he looks right now. I'm just going to try to put some details here and there, here and there. Yep. So this is my big tree. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm my only viewer. I'm so low on views. Okay, this should be the tree again. Let's export this tree. So big tree. Let's go to Maya. And let's kill this big tree. But it's my old big tree. Die. And let's bring the new tree, big tree. I know. And it's way better. So you can see it's working. We have a tree. Let's put the information. Let's save this scene as a new scene with light block tree. And let's try a new render. So we have almost the full scene working. And it's too bright. So I'm going to change the perspective exposure. Maybe 400? No, it should be so maybe 200 speed, 400 the shutter speed. It should be something like this. And for the exposure photographics, I think that should be it. Right now I have the basic shape for everything. If I go and smooth things out from here, you can see that I have things working. So I have the shape and it looks like I have the shape. So let's try to get a little bit more of detail from this shape. I think this thing is flying. So let's make it not fly. This one shouldn't be flying. So this is water. You should stay underwater. You don't need to be there. Okay, so now I have my basic mesh. Let's select everything. And I have this thing working. Let's see. Here, this one should be over here. And at last, I have everything blocked out. Something like this, because I have a shrub there. So I have to think where I want him to be growing. So I want him to be growing over here. So let's try to get this shrub here. This guy and this guy. So this guy, it's maybe not. See, it's a plane. So let's have a plane. And this plane, it's going to live here. Like Bob Ross is making everything. Everyone lives over somewhere. So we... This is my basic plane. And let's remove all the subdivisions to one and to one. And let's try to get the shape of this shrub. I'm going to remove this guy just to hide him. Here's that should be here, and let's make the first loop. He should be here, and over here. I don't know how much detail do we want him, so I'm going to make the detail later. So this other guy should be here, and it's getting smaller on the side, maybe bigger over here. And with this extrude, the extrude should be done on the edge, not on the vertex, right? So with extrude, I can't work with him. So this is it. And the last of these guys. So it's him. It's the fat leaf. So this guy should be like that. And this guy should be something over here. And the 2 points here and here. And if I want to have feeling that I'm making it right and fatter, I should add some more resolution. And I find this one thinner. And this one, okay. So I have the shrubs as they look on the render. And let's see if I get this thing right. Yep, as you saw, on that side of the fern, of the thing, the perspective is quite right because it's almost on top of the dune that I just make on the shore. And it's working. She's an art, a perfect artist. He got all the perspective right. I don't know how the hell did she did this thing to work the way it's working, but she's amazing. This is another artwork from Skylar, and she's great. This was a speed paint. The only thing that I can think of is that she was using references, because even on the bear, it was so accurate, the perspective that I have to make for the model. It was great to work with her and to see the artwork. I don't know, I'm bluffed about the work that she did and everything. It's amazing. So I'm getting a little bit from the model. I should make this thing go a little bit here and here, and this one is here. Okay, so I have my three leaves there. I should make more leaves on the other side, but I don't want to make leaves yet, just yet. So I'm going to move this guy. The representation, it's similar, but this one appears to be on the back part, and this one is like a very, very first plane. So I'm making them to be closer. And I should turn off this geometry also, because I'm not going to be able to see anything if I leave these guys on. So let's turn everything off and let's try to get these guys to work the way they should. So for this one, it's over here and over here. And they appear to be falling over that side. So I'm going to get the basic shapes first. And after that, I'm going to make them fall. I have to make the other guys fall also. I'm just making on one side. So this other guy here. So right now I have to make the other side of the trees. I think there are some trees here and some other things that I have to model for the scene to work and for the lighting to work. Not just making the basic scene and that's it. So it's going to take a while to populate the scene, but I'm going to try to make everything out with models and with geometry, planes, and maybe some alphas here on these bushes, and some of the leaves are going to be alphas and the flowers and everything. So I'm going to try to make everything in my stream. It's a really difficult task, but it should have a great image at the end of the stream. And I hope everybody can see the stream and like the stream. Right now it's just modeling. But after that, all the process creating the alphas and everything, that was going to be awesome. Actually, I'm really expecting that part. I really like that part of the asset creation and everything. It's funny. We almost have no time to do that when we are working and actual work to do everything. It's more complex and we only do a little bit of stuff, and maybe the studios and the big studios, we don't like the work of, or we should, with maybe it's not we don't like, it's that we have different solutions to the problems. It's like, why did you do that thing that way? It should be better if you use it this way. And so it's great to have some free time and to work on the way that you guys love to work and to make your own projects and to really think and try the work that the other guys on the big studios does, not just your own work, or if you're a freelance artist, you have to do almost anything, almost everything. But again, if you have the possibility to work on your own stuff and to make everything on a big project, just try it. Try the best way to do it. Try to achieve a result and to get a nice result at the end, and to get to know that things that are hard for the other guys. That way you're going to be a perfect partner, and they are going to, oh man, I really like to work with this guy. He actually knows what he's doing. He thinks ahead of time and give me all the things that I really need. You don't, when you're working on a studio and everything is so stressful, and you're seeing everything, and you're seeing the guys that are doing their job, and you don't actually care. It's so different when you're with guys that love what they're doing and know what you're doing and try to help you and even solve your problems before you have said anything to them. That's so great that you feel like, oh man, I really, really love this job. I really love to work with these guys. They are amazing. They help me a lot. It's a great feeling when you have not only your part of the knowledge, and you just not, you can't do everything, but you shouldn't, but you should know a little bit about everything. It's wise to get ahead of time and to try different things, to get out of your comfort zone and work that way. It's like me, I hate rigging. I don't really like rigging. I have to know rigging. I know a little bit, but not that much, but I know the behavior. I know what the guys need, and as a modeler, I know what a rigger likes, and if I have to work with a modeler, with a rigger, I tend to work with him. I ask him what do he likes, how he prefers the geometry to be and the loops and everything. I know I'm the modeler. I know that I should decide everything, but he's the rigger. He's the one that will have to struggle with everything and every of my decisions. So why not try to take him into account and to ask him the way that he would like to have something. So for me, at least, that's a nice way to be a partner. And I have found some guys that work that way, and that feeling, it's like, oh, I want a beer with this guy, or I really want to work again with him. And when you have that feeling with a partner, even if that's a freelance, you know that you're going to work again with him. And if you gotta work a job that you need to do, you're going to look for this guy, and you're going to try to get the render done with this guy. So try to get that out, try to get everything there. And I think that I'm not using the correct, I'm seeing more that I've seen on the cutout here. I'm seeing a little bit more on the render. So that's not right. Why I'm seeing more? This one shouldn't. Okay, maybe I have a pre-scale. Yeah, I have a pre-scale. That's the thing that I'm doing. 1.2. That's a post-scale. So this one should be the one that I'm seeing. Nope. So I should unblock everything. We'll go for a zoom. I'm going to unlock. I should save and select my camera and make something that I shouldn't. Let's pray. Unlocked. camera settings, bookmarks, edit bookmark, new bookmark, and zoom. Over here, I lost everything. So there, I have something, and I don't have something here, and it's not working anymore. So that was my mistake. Hey, here is working, almost working. Here is working. Okay, it's working again. Okay, okay, okay. Now it's not working. Let's go back to the bookmark. Let's see. Let's go back to the prescale. Let's look. It's working at least. Some sort of thing. I didn't want to do that. Okay. Let's see. I have a zoom somewhere. Camera scale. This one should be 0.8. And with this one. Okay. It's working again. I didn't want to go to camera scale, but it's the same. And it's working now. So who cares? And right now I have the scene blocked out. You see? You can see everything? It's working! We have a bear! And the difference here are mostly on the shapes. My scene it's a little bit more curvy and fatter. Her work was more cuts and more blocks. I think it was because of the lasso tool. I'm not going to do that. It's so hard to get that stylized, that style. I think I don't want to do that first, and it will take me a lot of time, and I don't have that time. So I'm going just to fix the main parts and the way the render works, and I think it's time to start working on some of the materials. I'm going to work on the basic one, the most basic one, before the stream ends. I think tend to do the streams in 1 hour, 2 hours most. So let's go looking for the water. So this one, it's going to be my water plane. And if this one is my water plane, I should duplicate him, go under, and let's make a new cut over here and a new cut over here. And let's remove this part here and remove everything there. And maybe this part here and remove this one. Also for the sides, I don't want to remove everything there. I'm going to leave that part. This one is the floor, right? The seabed. So let's take this one out. I will need to model also something for the tree to stand. I don't have anything for the lock, for the dead tree to be, to stand and to exist. So I'm going to model something over here. I think that my little bird decided to sleep there through a walk. He was just walking over the river and found a seabed there. I think I went overboard with this part. Maybe he found a seabed over there and decide that he would like to live there. And I'm going to take this one out. I'm going to make export, extrude, and to take this one over here. And I'm going to make a cut to select that cut that I just made and to make a scale. I have the scale, and I'm going to go for a bevel, and add some segments. So now I have a quite good looking shape there. So maybe a little bit here and way over here. And now I have a nice looking thing. Let's keep working with this part. I'm getting this lock under something here. I don't want to see this guy. I just want to know that on my scene it's working and behaving at least close to correctly. So it should have something over here making him stand. And that something should be a new edge. Okay, so he's on top of there. I need to add rocks and other things, but we are still working on that and we are deciding the shapes. I need to fix the shape of the tree. Let's move this part just a little bit, just a tiny bit, to make it work the way it should. This is the guy that it's making my machine buggy. I don't know why. So it's stuck right now. Let's end the stream here. I'm back, my friend. Oh, hi, Game Art. You're here. I'm here again. I'm streaming. Different scene, different everything. And it's still stuck. Maybe I should do this on Sivers and not here again and again. Let me see if I think I'm still rendering. If I'm still rendering, I'm an idiot. Let's see. How are you, Game Art? What do you do for a living, actually? I don't know, what do you do for a living? I'm back. I'm back. Nice. I'm not going to touch again this guy. I really want to touch this guy. So maybe I'm going to come here. TMBMT for the move tool. BMT. And I'm going to make it to have something like this, and like this, and like this. So it's something like that. Let's export here, big tree, replace. I'm going to kill this one. And to import the big tree again. So right now, yeah, I don't care. Right now, I have the actual model here. So I think we are done with the model. Let's see. And let's make a quick render of this guy. It should be behaving almost the same. Oh, I don't have the water. I should make an API render. I'm working with Redshift right now and I don't have the water. I should put the water here and I need to add this part. Let's put the water again. Where is my water? I want my water back. Where are you? Where are you? My water is on top of you. Yep. Here's the water. Water. Okay, so I need to take this guy and this guy. I hate that. Okay, so I'm going to extract this geometry, and this geometry is going to be the water. Water. And now that I have Oh no, I put everything. I just extract this guy. So he's the water. Water. Thank you. Okay. So let's put the water the way it should. It's simple, a simple basic model. I'm not going to make a hard model, hard mesh. I'm going to use displacement for the water. I'm not going to go crazy making some rail flow thing. Maybe I should. I don't think so. I don't want to. Again, if you guys are working with guys that are doing something, some rail flow and everything, it's good if you try it. It's not easy to use. It's easy to use, but it's hard to get results. So maybe it's good for you to try and to see what results you can get and how to make things easier for the guys that are working with you and to have better results. And everybody's going to be happy and you're going to get better and you're going to know what the other guys are doing. So I think it's great. You should try it. I know I'm crazy. Okay, so I have everything. I'm going to center the pivot and to be here and to take this guy on top. And now that I have this guy here, I have to put him in a weird, I lost the angle. So it's a weird angle, something like that, like 6 point something. 6.53, something like that was the right angle. So I have the water, I have the little guy, I have everything here. And again, let's sculpt. No, maybe not. Maybe let's move this guy and hand. So this is the shore, and this is how I get the idea that this thing should work and should be seen. I don't care that back part there, and this one should be bigger, and this part, remember I did a strut here, so this part was not affected for the changes that I did before, so I need to fix this little guy to follow me through the changes. So whoa, go down. And I don't care about this part here, it's the environment. It's not going to have animation. I'm not going to do any kind of stuff over there. And I'm not going to try to make things here. So let's move this thing over here and move thing over here. And that's it. And let's get the plane of water again. So we have our water. And let's put a basic, pretty basic material. So let's go for a redshift material. And this one is going to be water. Attributes and custom, I have also water. So it's so easy with redshift. I know, it's not right. I have to fix some things, but I don't care. I have water. If you have free water, why should you complain? No, I don't want to complain. I have free water. So I'm going to make some subdivisions on the water. I'm not going to use a displacement map yet, but I want to see how this thing is looking on the render. So this is the water, and it's a hard water. I need to fix that part over there. And I have reflections, I have the shadows, I have everything. And this guy is looking great. So let's stop this thing. I need to fix the other. I'm going to fix the other part of the model. So I want to fix this guy. This one is easier. I just need to select him and to make him over here. And select this guy over here. And that's it. Just come to sculpt and to make a basic thing over here and a basic thing over here. And smooth here. So I have everything there. So that should be working. I will go through the water. And if I got the scene correctly, let's see. This is not a quite, it's a noisy water. It's not that perfect. So let's go for the color. The diffuse is okay. The reflections should be a little less. And the refraction color should be like the roughness. So let's try again with this configuration. Where's my render? So IPR. And that's it. That's it for today. Thank you for following me. Thank you for being here today. And this is the final render that we are going to get. We are almost done getting to the nature. So we're going to start making the rocks. We're going to start making the nature, the everything, the moss on top of the tree. And everything should be done. Thank you so much. And see you next time. Thank you. See you later.